The pinnacle of Hobart, towering high above Tasmania's capital city. Developer Adrian Bold believes Mount Wellington, also known as Kanunyi, is a missed opportunity for tourism and investment.
The vision for the project really is to open up better access and better enjoyment and better appreciation for Mount Wellington.
Putting forward plans to build a cable car from the city to the mountain, a vision that's attracted international investors and state government support. Not everyone is convinced it's a good idea.
Any form of scarring of this magnificent and deeply powerful, deeply important landscape, it's very concerning.
She says more consultation with Indigenous communities should have been conducted right from the beginning.
They're not in opposition, caring for country and development. They can actually work together, and we believe that when we're participating in the process, we can actually give clear guidance of how best to do that.
The developers say they're willing to listen and that the project will respect the Indigenous history of the land.
There's a lot of Indigenous heritage that goes wanting. There's a lot of information and many stories that people would be really willing to find out about, but there's a severe lack of understanding, a severe lack of interpretation available.
The Tasmanian Greens have an alternative concept for a $5 million walking track linking the mountain with the city centre. The idea of a cable car ferrying passengers to Hobart's highest point was first raised by locals more than 100 years ago. Since then, there have been four attempts to bring the vision to life. More than 10,000 Facebook fans say they want to see it happen. On the streets of Hobart, a mixed response.
I'm not so sure. I think it would spoil the nice settings we have here.
There'll be a public display and community consultation next month. In Hobart, Rhiannon Elston, NITV News.